Welcome to another exciting video here, High Levelers. In this video, what we're going to be covering is another new feature that was released this year at the High Level Summit, and that is going to be the form pop-up on hosted videos. Now, this right here seems a little bit complicated. I'm going to kind of go over and show you where you would use this and how this works. But before we get started, if you have not subscribed to my channel, smash the subscribe button. I do appreciate your support. So right now, what I'm going to do is probably going to be better to show you what this is rather than trying to explain it to you. So right now we've got a funnel built and we're going to go inside of our sites. And funny enough, the funnel is just called funnel. So we're going to load that up and then we're going to open up the builder here and see what this looks like. Now notice right here, this form pop-up on hosted video is a feature that Highlevel has just come out with. And one of the things about this is you have to have a video, I mean, obviously on your form, because it's a form pop-up for a hosted video. But the point of it is it's a way to be able to sit back and allow people to opt in to your video before they finish watching the rest of it. So think about if you're doing like a masterclass or any kind of training, or you're giving away some great information on a video, but you don't want to have people opt in for it first. Cause you know, maybe they might be like, I don't know about this. You know, this might be not so good. And so I'm not even going to bother trying to give my name and email address or my phone number or something like that to this person. But what if you had the ability on a funnel page or a landing page or something like that to give a video away for free that had really good content? Now, for the sake of this particular video, I think this one might be a shorter video, but imagine if you had a half an hour video where, you know, for the first 5 minutes, you really gave away some good information and really built the video up. And then after 5 minutes, you know, people are really engrossed. They're watching the video. They want to watch and see what comes next. At that point, you can tell the video inside of Highlevel, stop, halt. I need to pop up an opt-in form, and then if you want to move forward and watch the rest of the video, you have to put in your opt-in information then at that point. So that's when you can capture the information after you've already provided valuable information on the video if they want to get the remaining part of the video. So that sounds great. Now, how does it work? So let's go ahead and pop this up real quick and just see a preview of this. Make sure that we got this video loaded. This is
again for visiting
a real quick video of me. I just loaded it, but right now it's not a long video here. So what I'm going to do to get this configured, you're going to have to edit the video element. Now, I will make sure you understand this point I'm trying to make is in the phrasing of this video is the video has to be hosted inside of Highlevel. It cannot be a YouTube video and have this work. The video has to be uploaded into the media library, because if you guys didn't know, check out my other video that you can host videos inside of Highlevel, inside of the media. And guess what? There's no storage requirements that you have inside of Highlevel. You can upload as many things as you want. I think the only limit that you have that I can think about is that the video file itself has to be an MP4 format, and it has to be no bigger than 5 gigabytes. Come on, guys. 5 gig video, that's a huge video file if you got something that big. But hey, real quick, if you're interested in learning some more about the Go High Level platform and how you can make money, I have a free course in the description below. Click on the link. I teach you 8 different ways you can make money using the Go High Level platform with no money out of pocket. If you haven't signed up for Go High Level, there's a link below where you can sign up and get a free trial. Let's get back to the video. As long as you upload it and it meets those requirements, then you'll be able to choose that on this particular page, upload it to the media library. You come over here and just simply, I'm going to open up the element form. If you come over here, notice that there is a video element right here. That's all this is just a video element that we have. You're going to add that to the page, very similar that you've done with a lot of other builders. You're going to click on this and edit the properties. The properties are going to be over here to the right. You scroll down a little bit. Notice some of the options that you get, and I'm going to see about blowing this up a bit. Give me just a second here. But doesn't make it any bigger, but you have YouTube, Vimeo, Wistia, custom embed, HTML5, and there's a hosted video. So you do have the other options of loading the other videos on your page. That's not a problem. But if you want to use this new opt-in form type thing or a form type pop-up on this video, it has to be hosted. So enough about that. So we've got a hosted video. So if you scroll down a little bit further, I'm going to blow this up here. You notice that you get a bunch of playback controls. If you scroll all the way down, generate leads on video. This is it right here. This is the big guy here. Now, if you don't mind, give me a second here. Let me see if I can move myself here. Give me a second. There we go. But to generate leads from video. So this is off right now. So, and again, I'm going to read this in case you can't see it. You can embed a form into your hosted video, which enables you to capture leads while your viewers are watching. Now, if you want to do that, you can just simply click on this and you get a couple of different options. Hours, minutes, and seconds. What this is how long in the video do you want it to play before the pop-up happens? So right now, I'm just going to choose 5 seconds because the video I have isn't very long. So I just want to do 5 seconds. And after 5 seconds, bam, you know, the video gets halted or paused. The pop-up comes up. And then at that particular point, you have to opt in or you don't get to watch the rest of the video. Now, besides the time in the video that you want to actually set, again, hours, minutes, and seconds, you have to choose the form, the opt-in form that you want to actually select due to the opt-in. So here we're going to select on this. And I've got one just called opt-in form, just a very basic form. So just choose whatever form. You get a list of all the forms that are in your form library. So once you have this, we're going to go ahead and come up here to click save. Once we click save, we just want to give it a few seconds. Come over here and click refresh. Now, if this works correctly, what we're looking for is that you're going to see on the video, you're going to see it play, play, and play. And then after 5 seconds, if you look at counting, you should see a little pop-up come up that allows you to put in your, or requires you to put in your opt-in. Otherwise, you can't move forward. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. The suspense is building, I know. Let's pop this up and refresh. So as you see, notice this little lock button right here. Do you see that? Boom, there it is. So that right there is a really good trigger. It pops up the opt-in form. Now, I want to show you real quick here. I'm not sure if I can do this, but notice here in the background, notice what's happening to the video. It's spinning, 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 meaning it's not continuing to play. It's pausing until this opt-in form is filled out. And when somebody puts in their first name, last name, and phone number, boom, then that's it. They sign up, they opt in, they then go into your CRM system. Of course, this form can be a trigger. So you can have a workflow set up that's going to trigger off this new opt-in form that you have on this one, and it could do all the cool things that workflows can do. But if you don't want to, if you just click on this, then right now this is kind of what you get. It just kind of sits there, and this is a really cool feature because right now it puts that little lock next to it. Kind of gives you a key indicator that after 5 seconds, that's it. Then this thing becomes locked and you can't go any further. So if I want to go over here, notice I can't do that. I try to click further in the video over here to watch, like, and it says, you can't do that. You're going to have to opt in. So again, there's multiple different uses you can do this for. The biggest thing is to be able to suck somebody in with a really great video. I've seen this. A great choice for this is like a masterclass. If you want to give a masterclass away, just make it completely free. The people just click on the link, they go in there and they start watching it. So if you have a 30-minute video, you might make it 8-10 minutes. I mean, pick a point earlier in the video that you want to make sure you've given enough information and value that they're going to be like, man, I got to watch the rest of this video. This is a lot of great information. So then their almost curiosity is piqued. They're going to have to fill out this opt-in form in order to move forward because they don't want to not know what's in your video. So it's a really great sort of mental trick for marketing to sit back and collect leads without having an upfront opt-in page. See what I mean? So before, typically what you end up getting on an opt-in form is you have a landing page that tells a little bit of example about what it is, what the page is about, and then has like a little opt-in form. Click here to get your free report. Click here to get whatever. And here, watch the masterclass or something like that. So instead of building that first page, you can sort of let people's guard down by taking them directly to the second page, which would be the masterclass hosted video with maybe your virtual sales letter underneath it. And then you have that little lock on there. And then after 5 minutes, pow, they get this and they're like, you can't move forward unless you opt in. So at least I could follow up with you, if you're interested in my product. So anyway, guys, I hope you found that useful. That's a great use case for this example. Another great feature from Highlevel. And real quick, if you found this video useful, real quick, smash a like button on this one here. You know YouTube really likes it. Helps out with my statistics, helps me grow my channel. That's what I'm all about here. I'm trying to make more videos. It's promoting my videos more and more because of you, the viewer, clicking on them, saying that you like them. And again, if you have not subscribed, please click the subscribe button. Tell all your friends if you're looking for Go High Level information. My channel is one of the best. Take it easy and have a great day.